13, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Wait, I'm counting this wrong. I should really just get on my app. Oh, yeah. So, hello everyone. If you haven't noticed, I've been trying to make a flag, but for 4th of July, I'm having a hard time making this look good, so I'm just gonna use a map. Let's go all over here, like right in the middle. Alright, let me count this like pixel stuff again. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Alright, I'm counting 13. So let's do 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. All right, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 stars per row, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. How does that look so far? It'll work if we make the stripes 3 blocks long each. So that's one. Now let's do the red stripe. Geez, dimensions. Well, let's first off go 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you've noticed, I've been playing creative mode. Cause it's creative day. Well, just for the holiday. Okay, so. So that's 13. That's also 13. I'm gonna look up the exact dimensions of the flag real quick. Dimensions. Alright. So the common ratio is 2x3. Alright. So wait, I'm thinking of the 2 as in the length, and then the 3 as in the width. That doesn't help me at all. I'll just eyeball it. Alright, let's just go like another 6 blocks out. Oh, look about accuracy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright. So, for my plan today, I was going to make a flag that took up the entire space of this map. That's too much work. That is honestly way, way too much work. So we're going to half that significantly. When I mean half, I mean do a very small portion of that half. We're just going to do whatever is necessary to make a flag. Let's see how well it looks up on the map. It should look fine. Honestly, should. What we'll do is we'll get the little stripes in so I know where to put the stars. No, the baby guy. Oh, die. Didn't expect to die in one hit. Alright, so if I'm doing 3 for the stripes, let's get the stripes in, like the where the rows are. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And the top one's always red. Alright, any more whites. Yeah, one more white, and the bottom's always red too. Alright. Maybe you do have to go a little farther out with the red. Anyways, let's just get all this in. It shouldn't take very long because, heck, this is not the entire size of the map. But yeah, so the idea was to make custom art using the entire size of a map. So, in the actual live survival game, I was thinking of going out to an ocean where there's plenty of empty space that's not being utilized, and just make map patterns there. The only problem with that, it will take way too long, and too much of wool. A lot of wool. Like, I'm using a lot of wool here just doing a small design like this. It would be nuts to do a large pattern. But it would work. Because you are kind of stuck with the paintings you have in the game. But you can technically make any art piece that you can put anywhere on the wall of your home by just making it to a map. So, yeah. Would work, it would look nice, and most importantly, you made it yourself, which is the best part of being an artist, to some degree. Alright, it's looking nice so far. Looks like a plane of some sort. That's because we still got the... fill it all in. A lot of mobs spawning in the super flat land. That's because you can see them all, because the majority of the time, all the hostile mobs will also spawn in caves below you, which use up a lot of the available mob count that can actually be generated at a time. Oh, you hush. So because we can see everything, it looks like a lot more than there really is. No, An interesting thing, if you want a certain block, just press middle click on that block. And this way you can fill in little mistakes like that quickly. Which is only for creative mode. I think it may also work for survival, but you would actually need to have the block on you. It won't do anything if you don't actually have a block to begin with. I was also thinking about doing some fireworks if we had some extra time. So, we'll see after we finish this. We'll see. You know what? You're stuck there. Alright. So yeah, I don't plan on doing much for 4th of July. I was supposed to have plane tickets available for this week. I misread the dates when buying the plane tickets online and accidentally put down the next week. So I put down the wrong weeks. Fly up back home to visit my dad. Oh, come on! Get out of there! Can I throw those at you? No? I can do that. Rude. Alright, here we go. He is now part of the flag. Sacrifice will not be forgotten. Creative mode, we could do also other fun stuff. But that's only if you guys want me to. I got crazy things in mind. But a lot of it just take forever doing in survival. I could also do it in survival, but some of that stuff I don't plan on doing until I get to like episode 100. Because at the rate I'm making my videos. It's gonna take a long time for a lot of things. Oh, come on. Don't make me have to spawn a good weapon to kill you guys. Getting in the way of America. Jeez. Natives. Anyway. I had another idea. Villages is saying we're going to declare independence on a village and like free them from their mob terrorism. No. No. Because in a way, it would just be a little bit inappropriate, I think. Because the mobs, they're generally peaceful. Like, look at them. He's a nice guy. He's not going over there blowing stuff up. He's just minding his own business, being a leafy, creepy mob. That's my agree. He's peaceful. Now, the zombies may be a little bit mean, but you know, they just want hugs. They hug the villagers until they become huggers themselves. So in a way, they're not bad either. They just want hugs. The skeletons, I've seen them shoot at villagers before. That's a little bit rude. Then again, I've always thought the skeletons were a little bit rude to begin with. Always in your face. Always wanting attention. They even ride other mobs once in a while. The baby zombies don't know any better, so that's why they ride chickens, copying their others that they look up to, like the skeletons. But the grown-up zombies know better. Yeah. They know not to get involved in that peer pressure business. And just do what they think is right. Which is use their own 2 feet. Yeah, so this isn't gonna take long, much more. The hardest part is probably gonna be the stars. And get the... do eyeball this correctly. Oh, I just thought of something. The flag isn't supposed to touch the ground. But this is being made into the ground. So doesn't that mean that it's technically touching the ground? I guess we're gonna have to fix that. But I'm still doing how to do this properly. Oh, it's almost daytime in the game. There's no real fast way to dig this unless I had mods. Like a mod of... to dig out an entire area all at once. Or a mod... Now that I need to dig all this out, just place the blocks on top of it. Oh well, I already started doing this. At least it's easy to walk around on it. One of my other ideas to do for this was to make fireworks and shoot them off. That's more or less easy to do, and I can probably still do that. All you need is firework charges in the game. And that's vanilla, so... We could do that. It'll just be a little bit difficult to set it up. It would look nice. Also, what would you do for colors and everything? You're kind of limited. But we'll think of something. We'll think of something. Also, setting it up where it automatically activates. Well, that I think would be a lot easier because at that point, you can just set up a day and night sensor, well, a light sensor, and do a little inverter on it so that as soon as it turns night, it gets inverted and will activate at night. And then fire off the fireworks all at once. Or at a sequence, depending on if you put repeaters on it to delay or not. Looking good. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to make this longer that way. Significantly. If it's that big, I feel as though we should make the stripes a lot bigger too. Well, not the stripes, the stars area. Okay, well, let me count the stars. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 stars per... per column. I was trying to think how to say that. Super, what's that word? That means up and down. Oh, that's what I call them. If we do this, would they fit? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, they would easily fit. One, two, three, four, five. Kind of hard to get them to fit. Oh, I was up by one. This is a little bit irritating. Trying to get the symmetrics down properly. If we take out one line out of everything, let's see how that turns out. If we do that, we're gonna have to stop for the middle, then work our way outwards. That means I did a lot of that work for nothing already. Oh gosh, well, let's just live with this. No, because it's off. It's off a little bit. Alright. It can't be that bad to fix it. Alright, so, whoops, a white would go there, red would start there, white would be there, red would start there, This would be the end of the flag right here. This is the end of the flag. And we're trying to keep a blue right there. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're still off by one. Oh, that's annoying. If we don't do that, but we just do one block. Like that, just keeping one block at the very end. How much blocks we got in the middle? So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 blocks. And we need 3 more out of that. Well, that's already 4. Like, 1, 2, 3. I don't know why I was thinking. Let's just do that. That looks horrible. It honestly does. It looks horrible. This all looks bad. Yes. I'm horrible at making flags. Thing is, the problem with flags is it has some sort of detail to them. So if you don't go zoom out far enough, or you don't zoom in enough, the quality of it won't be there. So you had to sacrifice somewhere. And that's why I was kind of sacrificing with, just doing dots for the stars instead of doing actual stars. Because it would be nearly impossible to do nicely detailed stars. What we'll do is move this all just down by a couple. This way it's at least somewhat in a pattern. It's just the bottom of the flag has a little bit more room to it. Less room to it, and the top of it does. But oh well. Oh well. I want these to be squared. So let's see. If we do that. But then we need to keep it squared right. Actually, we'll just put it like right there. Then, so 1, 2, 3. So I had 1, 2, 5, 6. Let's get rid of all that for now. Instead of going over the flag I already have put there, I'm just going to go up that way. See, I should have done all the stars first, because if I got the stars done, everything else should have fallen in place. What am I thinking? I need to make that square, because those are squared. Well, it is Sunday after all, for me. Yeah, I shouldn't have even said that, because you thought my thing was on Monday. This is a Monday video. Then again, I guess most of you should have known that I am not playing this live on a recording. Like, oh my gosh, I'm watching him playing it right now. He must be actually playing it right now that I can pause and rewind and watch him do the same thing over again. I hope some people out there don't think that. I honestly hope. I kind of expect even younger kids. Mostly toddlers. Because they're not used to technology yet. But, yeah, I wouldn't expect that from at least, like, 6 and up, at least. Because at that point, they've been around long enough to see technology, know how it works, how the general gist of things are. So we're gonna get all these white stars in, and we'll just run around and do all the blue. Playing other games for Independence Day. I was thinking about playing Factorio and saying that we're going to liberate or bring independence to an alien planet by making factories to pollute the entire countryside, but no. That is also a little bit inappropriate to do and say. There's quite a few things I could play and could say during these videos. They would be somewhat humorous, but they would not be appropriate. No, I guess an enderman spawned. I didn't think they could spawn in rain. I thought they would just refuse to spawn. Because it's technically a hostile area for them to spawn, but no. I guess the game just hates them enough where it wants to bring them pain at whatever time is whenever possible. I'm thinking that this flag is more of a giant checkerboard more than anything else at this point. Well, I am still determined to finish this. Oh yeah, so I would like to keep talking constantly, but honestly, there isn't enough things to talk about without general feedback. So if you have anything to say, like you want more videos, or you don't like certain aspects of the videos, that would be awesome to tell me. Like, I've been cutting out a lot of footage because of boring parts, like just doing nothing but random buildings like this. Like when I was working on my tower, I cut out a lot of footage of that because I didn't think people would like that. But I had to do some part of the video. Like, I tried doing up to 30 minutes worth, usually. So that's why there's like some parts of it where it's just boring. Because you just watch me build straight up in a column. But believe me, I cut out a lot of repetitive stuff like that. So yeah, if you want to see boring repetitive stuff that I consider boring and repetitive and not fun to watch, let me know so I can not cut any of that out. It would just mean there would be a lot more episodes of doing the same thing. But that was the other part. I was trying to keep certain goals to one video. Like when I was liberating those villages or securing the villages. I've been trying to keep those to one video for each village. Because technically that's their own episode. But you don't mind me making multiple episodes per operation, so you get to see me do boring individual stuff like this, either this or exploring, nothing really happening, but it could be. You don't want me to cut any of that out, then I won't. Oh, another interesting thing is when I was starting these videos, I was thinking of it being a no commentary series where every single one of my gameplay videos would be up 100% no commentary. If you like me to start a series like that, I wouldn't mind, because that was the original plan for me to begin with before I started doing any sort of gameplay or videos. Back in when I was making those random videos I have in my random folder, random playlist, that was going back maybe to 2011, I think. Yeah, that was in plans 2011. This looks horrible, but you know what? At least I have the stars there. Yeah. Let's just get the stripes looking nice now. You got the, you understood the general purpose of this? Just use the map. Just use the maps to make your artwork that you want to hang around. The only problem is, I don't think some maps would show anything if you're not there. I think they would still show another thing, but they just wouldn't update unless you bring that map back. Yeah, this is almost like I've been saying repeatedly because I want it to be done so I can start the actual next videos. Because if I'm doing this for the 4th, you know, I gotta make one for the 5th, I gotta make one for the 6th. Technically, this day is nothing but recording day for me. I was going to do some Saturday, but I was not in the mood. I just wanted to sit in one spot, do nothing. But yeah, today I went out of the house, drove around for a bit. Went to the store, noticed all the parking was full, drove back home, figured I'll go out later when the parking doesn't get as full. So yeah, this is looking somewhat nice. We just have to make the flag longer. But let me see how much time the video is on. Technically, this video is already out of time. But yeah. Here we have the general idea of the flag. But now let's actually finish this idea. So, the entire idea is to hang up the flag as such. So yeah. The flag is no longer on the ground. Nope, no longer on the ground. And you can see the other flag I was doing over there. This actually looks a lot nicer than what I thought it would turn out to be. And technically, it doesn't seem like it took all that much time. But yeah, it did take around half an hour to figure out how to do the design of it and everything. But overall, it doesn't look too bad. It looks like you can do individual pixels, individual blocks, and it should be seen very visibly. This update? No, it looks like you have to actually go a little bit farther out, maybe? Get away from that. No, it doesn't update. You need to break it. Yeah, you'd have to break it. But yeah. Flag. Alright, since the sun just came up, I can't really do fireworks. But since I just wanted to make a flag video, custom artwork that you can make with maps. That's all I wanted to show off. So, yeah, this is not a finished flag, but I technically don't have enough time to make a flag. And I don't want to take up your entire time watching this, so you can go out and enjoy your 4th of July. Talk to you later! Bye!